अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू अनदर इंफॉर्मेटिव वीडियो। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज द डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर। इन दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न व्हाट इज डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर, व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर, हाउ डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर इज क्रिएटेड, व्हाट इज द यूनिट ऑफ डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर, द रिकमेंडेड स्टैंडर्ड्स बाय WHO फॉर डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर, व्हाट इज द प्रिकॉशंस व्हिच मस्ट बी फॉलोड फॉर द डिफरेंशियल प्रेशर, एंड then we will discuss types of pressure, mean what is the positive pressure, what is the negative pressure for tablet manufacturing area, which type of pressure is maintained, and for sterile manufacturing area which type of pressure is created or maintained. So let's start our video. What is the differential pressure? Basically, differential pressure is the difference of pressure between manufacturing area and its adjacent area. In simple words, the difference of atmospheric pressure of manufacturing area to the adjacent area, which is corridor, is known as differential pressure. Which device is used to measure differential pressure? Many of you working in pharmaceutical industries are familiar to this type of the device and this type of the device. This device is known as MagniHelic and this one is known as manometer. Manometer. These are used to measure the differential pressure. MagniHelic gauge measure the differential pressure in pascals and manometer measure differential pressure in inches of water column. In manometer, we have a small glass rod which is filled with red color liquid material, and here we have a knob. You can change the position of liquid material to adjust it to zero by rotating the knob, and this is the MagniHelic gauge where we have a needle which indicate the pressure values are from 0 to 30 on one side and 0 to 30 on other side. So what is the importance of differential pressure? Differential pressure in pharmaceutical industries is very important because the difference of the pressure is created between two adjacent areas to prevent contamination or cross contamination. So what is the standard by WHO, mean what are the standard values for differential pressure by WHO? And according to WHO guidelines for HVAC, the differential pressure is usually set between 10 to 15 Pascal. For inches of water column, you can simply convert by using any converter to check the values for inches of water column. As we discussed, units of differential pressure are Pascal, and inches of water column is also a unit in which differential pressure is measured. How differential pressure is created? We have discussed what is the differential pressure. So we also discussed in importance of differential pressure is in clean rooms where we manufacture, dispense our drugs. And this pressure is created by the HVAC, heating, ventilation and air conditioning system. If you are not familiar with HVAC, the link of playlist regarding heating, ventilation and air conditioning system is given in the description. You can watch the playlist to understand complete working and principle of HVAC. What are the precautions which must be followed to maintain the differential pressure? Basically, no leakages should be observed between the rooms or windows of the processing area to the adjacent area, because if any leakages are observed, the air will leak through these leakages or gaps and differential pressure will drop. Next one is that we built a airlock between our manufacturing area and our corridors to maintain the differential pressure at its standard values. The next one is that the gauges which we use to indicate the differential pressure must always be calibrated, and we also check the HVAC recovery test or recovery time to understand that how much time is required to maintain the differential pressure by HVAC if our electrical breakdown is observed. Or the next one is the simple explanation of differential pressure. Basically, we can maintain two types of differential pressures. One is positive pressure and one is the negative pressure. Positive differential pressure or negative differential pressure. Positive differential pressure means inside is positive and our corridor is negative. And negative differential pressure means our processing area or manufacturing area is negative and corridor is the positive. So when we use positive differential pressure and when we use negative differential pressure to maintain the sterility or to prevent the contamination of our clean room, we use positive differential pressure and to prevent the cross contamination or to prevent the outflow of dust generation in the manufacturing area or to prevent the outflow of hazardous substances, we use negative differential pressure. In table manufacturing area, the manufacturing area is kept at negative pressure and the corridors are at positive pressure. So air pass from clean corridor to the manufacturing area means air which is going from corridor to inside is the clean. And if clean corridors are not available, we always built a airlock, and from airlock air enter into the primary manufacturing area. We maintain negative pressure inside to prevent the outflow of dusty particles which are generated during the granulation area. So always air goes from outside to the inside granulation area and this prevent the cross contamination. In the sterile manufacturing area, the concept is reverse, where we have to maintain our sterile area and to maintain its sterility. That is why air always moves from inside to the outside. That is why our manufacturing area is always kept at the positive pressure. So air moves from inside to the outside. This outflow of air always restrict the entry of microbes or contaminants to the inside of the area. I hope you are now familiar with the concept of differential pressure, how differential pressure is maintained. For a brief overview, the difference of pressure between two adjacent areas in pharmaceutical industries mean manufacturing area and corridor area is known as differential pressure. Where these gauges are installed, basically these are installed at the doors outside of the area. Mean if we have a airlock, one gauge will be installed and it will display the readings of inside pressure. And if we have airlock system, one gauge will be installed outside the door towards the corridor, which will display the value of the pressure inside the airlock. So it was a video about the differential pressure, importance of differential pressure, units of differential pressure, how it is created. If you like the video, share it to others and do subscribe my channel and also visit my website pharmainform.com for reading more interesting and informative articles. Till the next video, Allah Hafiz.